Hello everyone, and once again welcome back to Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. So this video is going to be very special because as I promised that we will start a new interview sessions for the experts in this field in our thank you video. So this is going to be the first one in that series, and I'm very fortunate and happy to present that our first guest of this video series is Arun Potti. You all might be already knowing him through his blogs and articles. So today it's our honor and privilege that he is with us. So without wasting much of your time, let's get started. Subscribe to Dynamix Academy and press the bell icon on your YouTube app to never miss a video from Dynamix Academy. Hey, hi Arun, welcome to Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. First of all, I would like to thank you for giving your valuable time for our audience and sharing your interviews with us. Already people might be knowing you very well through your blogs and your articles, but just for the sake of formality, can you just tell our viewers about something about yourself and your personal background?
Sure, Abhishek. So I am Arun Potti, having 10 plus years of experience in .NET and Dynamics CRM and Azure. And I am from the green and beautiful city, Visakhapatnam, Andhra Pradesh. In my family, along with my parents and my wife with Deepika, I also have a 2 years old, very energetic and adorable son. His name is Srived. And also I have a younger brother. His name is Aditya and got recently married to Grishma. That's all about my personal background.
Thank you, Arun, for sharing your personal background. So on that note, can you just little bit tell our audience about your educational background?
Sure, Abhishek. I have completed postgraduate program in artificial intelligence and machine learning from the University of Texas at Austin recently. And also I completed a master's in computer education from Noble Institute of Science and Technology, Andhra Pradesh, and which is from Andhra University.
Oh, that's great to hear. You have completed your master's in AI recently. That means still you are studying. That's good to know about yourself. And we'll try to see much more of that in your articles as well.
Sure.
Thank you. So along that same line, can you just tell some more, a little bit about your work experience as well?
Sure, Abhishek. So I have total 10 plus years of experience in .NET and Microsoft Dynamics CRM and in Azure. Started my career as a developer in Mahindra Satyam. Formerly it was Satyam actually. Now it's Tech Mahindra. So in Visakhapatnam, I have joined in the year 2010, and later I moved to Hyderabad and I worked there for 3.5 years. After Tech Mahindra, I joined Tata Consultancy Services as a systems engineer in the year 2014. And I worked there for 8 months. After TCS, actually, while working at TCS, I got an opportunity to work with Microsoft as an FTE in the year 2014. Since then, it has been more than 6+ years at Microsoft now.
Oh, that's great. Wonderful journey till now. So it's more than 6+ years in Microsoft. So can you just a little bit share about your hobbies and interest, what you like to do in your spare time?
Sure, Abhishek. So, well, frankly speaking, you can call me as a numismatist. I love to collect coins and currencies, and you know that I have more than 15 plus different types of currencies of different countries, and I'm looking for some more. If you have some, you can give it to me. I'll happily collect and store it with me. Speaking about my interest, I like to watch movies, especially action and comedy genre movies. That's all, actually.
You have, at this point in time, you are holding 15 plus different types of currencies. That's good. That's something, a new angle that I knew about yourself, because we knew each other since so long, right? So this is something new which even I'm learning, so it would be great for our audience as well. So now coming to the most awaited question of this interview, everybody would be waiting to know about yourselves, like since when you have joined in Microsoft and how is your journey till now in Microsoft?
I have joined Microsoft in the year 2014. To be honest, it has been a great journey till now, so far, which has been. And I started my career as associate consultant in 2014. And as of now, I'm currently working as a techno-functional consultant. During this entire tenure with Microsoft, I got to play different kinds of roles in projects like developer, lead, support consultant, deployment administrator, and architect. And even I got to travel on-site locations. I traveled actually to US and Qatar multiple times. So even that's also quite different types of experience for me. And one thing I have noticed after coming to MS is that change is inevitable. it keeps on changing, not only the technological aspects, but even internal alignments keep on changing. You got to play different role, project and managers, teams, and even the domains that you are currently aligned to keep changing. So that is something I like about MS. Hence, it's a nutshell. As I said earlier, it has been great and wonderful journey so far.
That's amazing. That's amazing, Arun. So as you mentioned that you have to keep on changing your roles and you have to play different types of responsibility during 6+ years of tenure with Microsoft. That's so really amazing that everybody should learn that change is inevitable. That's the one of the key aspect that one can take from this question. Even in technology space, Microsoft has changed so many aspects since 2011. And now every 6 months they keep rolling out. So it's not only the technological aspects, but internally it gets changing. That's amazing to know about your Microsoft journey till now. So let's say you already shared some of the useful tips in the previous question, but again, let's say somebody wants to join Microsoft or somebody who is preparing for Microsoft interviews, then what would be your valuable tips to him that how he can prepare and how he can keep himself ready for Microsoft interviews?
That's an interesting question, Abhishek, and which is very useful for everyone. Well, if you're aspiring to join MS, then my advice would be to have thorough understanding of the knowledge that they have and the basics, which mean, and fundamentals of any technology domain that you're working, which is like Microsoft technologies, I mean to say. For example, if you're looking to apply Dynamics CRM area, then I suggest to have best and deep understanding of Dynamics CRM, basics like workflows, plugin pipelines, and all the out-of-the-box features, and also like C#. Also real-time working experience on different real-world scenarios in Dynamics CRM, which will help really to go through that interview process. And one thing that I can share from my experience is that one should not stick to the work assigned to him or her. I would like to emphasize here that you must explore more and gain more knowledge on the new changes that we have in the technology, which is trending in the market today. And lastly, don't forget to check MS Careers website for demo interviews and the JD job description and how to approach Microsoft interview section. That would be more than enough.
Amazing tips that you have shared. Very useful. Even I can relate to that. A point that you have made is one should not stick to the work assigned to him or her in their daily project task, but they should look broadening their horizon and knowledge. Because whatever you are learning today, whatever you know today, we never know that it will be the same in future as well. Because every 6 months, Microsoft is changing the technology front as well. And the last tip as well, whatever you mentioned, is very relevant because one should go to the JD as well as they should check the Careers website for demo interviews. That would really help to crack the deal when they're applying for Microsoft interviews. So I think those are the two and most key valuable aspects they can take from this. Thank you for sharing those amazing tips. So having said that, I know you personally since like more than 5 years now, and plus even in Microsoft, we are working in same project. I know how busy you are, and not only from your project perspective, plus even you, as you mentioned that you have gone through the Masters in AI course. So how do you keep balance, or how you manage your time and work-life balance, how you keep that is something really amazing about yourself. So can you just share that secret with us?
Well, I simply follow a strict policy that I work hard during the weekdays, the Monday to Friday, and try to close all the tasks in the work week itself, and then completely dedicate my time on Saturday and Sunday to my family. So which is simple and effective strategy that I follow while working hard and have family time during weekends.
It's true, right? If you follow the strict timeline, that would be, you would be able to divert your time and attention to wherever it is required. Now, coming to the most interesting and most awaited question from your interview would be, since when you started blogging and what was your source of inspiration? Like, how did you started writing the blogs? Can you share some lights on that?
Sure, Abhishek. So I started blogging since 2014 when I was at in TCS, I have started this. So honestly speaking, when I actually started working in CRM, there were not enough resources in the internet that would explain detail step-by-step for a fresher to learn and gain knowledge in CRM out of it actually. So I started blogging and writing articles in details and easy to understand with the tasks that and items that works and those which I myself have implemented successfully in my projects. Till today, I have posted more than 300+ articles and I would like to thank everyone for following my blog and going through my articles. I just hope that you all like it and you can share your valuable feedback on the articles and the blog posts which I have done. I love to go through all your comment and feedback that helps me to improve myself and grow.
Not only that time itself, even today there are very less articles which would be explaining in detail and easy to understand format. Even if it is a fresher or an experienced person, if they can simply get 100% working results from your article. So that's really an amazing USP that you are having. And thank you for sharing that valuable knowledge. And please do keep sharing those knowledge with our audience.
Sure, thanks.
Having said that, like as we mentioned, Microsoft itself is changing its technology stack every 6 months. Then how do you cope up with this change? How do you keep yourself updating and what are your source of learnings? Like, can you share that with us?
Yeah, sure, Abhishek. So I follow a Microsoft Dynamics CRM community, Microsoft Learn, LinkedIn and Plural site, and some of the CRM blogs. I follow all these.
Okay. So it's a virtually same learning source for everyone which is available in public domain. So there is nothing a secret sauce. So it's something like everyone has to devote their personal time and learn the best of it. We will be posting all the links of these resources in our video description. Since you are working in this domain since more than 10 plus years, so what would be your observation and your take on the future of Dynamics 365 or Power Platts in terms of growth and opportunities?
From my point of view, I have observed that the market cap of Dynamics CRM and Power Platform has grown up tremendously over the last couple of years. So without the doubt, there is a huge demand on sound, technical, functional, and admin professionals in this space. Also, I can see lots of opportunities in the upcoming period for Dynamics 365 and Power Platform due to its low-code, no-code features, which enables the non-technical and non-developers community to start building great and powerful apps as well as automate their day-to-day task with ease. And also, since Microsoft will keep updating its product every 6 months, as you said, so even experienced professionals had to keep updating their skills after every update. For example, CRM has lots of capabilities like integration with Azure, Power Apps, Power Automate, Power BI, Customer Voice, and AI Insights, Virtual Bots, Themes, and a lot. And lastly, now customers are adopting Office 365, Dynamics 365, Power Platform, and Azure for their digital transformation. Hence, I can very well say that there are lots and lots of opportunities for everyone to explore in this area.
Okay, that's very interesting insight that you have shared with us. You have mentioned very correctly that every 6 months it is getting changed. Not only the freshers, but even the experienced person has to keep updating themselves because the technology itself is changing rapidly. So everyone has to keep on their toes and learn the new things so that they can get benefits out of it. And plus, as you correctly mentioned, that the market cap has been increased and there will be huge demand for sound technical and functional professionals. That's true. Thanks again for sharing this insight. Coming to your next question, like what are your upcoming plans, if you have any, would you like to share with us?
Sure, Abhishek. So as we are discussing offline that we both now will be collaborating more often on Dynamics Academy in terms of writing articles, blogs, frequent video sessions on specific topics as well, conducting live sessions once in a while. And also I'll be posting articles on my blogs as usual. Now, speaking from personal point of view, I'm planning to learn how to drive a car in next quarter.
We would love to go for on a long trip once you learn that.
Sure, absolutely.
And thanks. Yeah, as we were discussing offline that we would be interacting more and collaborating more in terms of how we can take this to a next level, all the interaction, so that it will benefit us as well as the larger audience as well. So thank you for giving your time and collaborating with us. Having said that, Stan, if you look back in your past journey, what would be your key advice to your younger self? Or let me rephrase this question. Let's say somebody who is starting his career right now, then what would be the key advice that you would give to someone who is starting their career right now?
That's an interesting question. By the way, one thing that I have learned throughout my career over 10 years now is that one should never be too long in your comfort zone. Keep pushing yourself to learn something new and practice those to master that skill. And however, if you like, then keep sharing knowledge to everyone.
That's true. Very rightly said by you that one should not be in the comfort zone for too long. Otherwise, it would be stagnant and they will hinder their future growth as well. So yes. Before going to the last question, let's say if somebody wants to contact you, how can they reach out to you?
That's very simple, Abhishek. Anyone can reach out to me on LinkedIn. And also they can reach out to me through my blog, through comment section. I'll be glad to respond to all your questions and queries.
So audience, you can see his LinkedIn profile URL on your screen, as well as we'll keep this URL in the description box as well. Apart from that, he already mentioned that you can post your questions and query in the comment box of articles. And from there also, you can connect with him. So thanks, Arun, for sharing that profile URL. And having said that, let's now conclude this interview. What would be your final remarks or anything you, that you would wish to share with our larger audience? We would be glad to know that.
First of all, I would like to thank you very much, Abhishek, for reaching out to me and making out this video, and thankful to all my blog followers. And hope I have helped you through my blog. Please share your valuable feedback on my blog.
Yes, yes. Thank you. We all like your blog and whatever the amazing work that you are doing for the community. We definitely, those are very good resources that you are sharing with the fresher as well as even the experienced professional. So please do keep sharing that. And we also thank you for taking your time for this interview. And we would hopeful doing the same in future aspects as well. So on that note, thank you, Arun. Bye-bye. Take care. We will catch you next time soon.
Thank you, Abhishek. For everyone, stay safe and take care. Thank you, everyone.
I thank you for watching this video till the end. So if you have learned something new out of this video, then please like, share and subscribe to Dynamix Academy. And also press the bell icon so that you will never miss any update whenever we release a new video to our Dynamix Academy YouTube channel. And on that note, I end this video and take your leave. Hope to see you all in the next video. Till then, bye-bye and take care. And once again, thank you for your time.